Hi students, today we are going to learn how to solve system of congruence in two variables. Before we begin, let's understand what is such a system. Here, let's say we are given two congruences, ax plus by is congruent to c mod m and a dash x plus b dash y is congruent to c dash mod m. You will notice the congruences have two unknowns x and y and they have a common modulus m. Such a system is called a system of congruence in two variables x and y with the moduli m. Now the question is, does such a system always have a solution? No, not necessarily. The answer is, such a system has a solution if and only if the determinant of the coefficients from the congruence and m, the modulus, whenever they are relatively prime, then the system has a solution. In other words, whenever the GCD of the determinant and the modulus is 1, then the solution is solvable. So, here we see we have the determinant as AB dash minus B into A dash modulus M. And if the GCD is 1, it is solvable. So, let's say that one solution of such a system was X naught and Y naught. Then all x which are congruent to x naught and all y which are congruent to y naught mod m are the solution. We write the general solution as x is equal to x naught plus mt, y is equal to y naught plus mt, where t value takes all the values 0 plus minus 1 plus minus 2. This gives us infinite solutions. Let's come to an example. What if we are asked to solve the system 5x plus 3y is congruent to 2 mod 14 and minus 3x plus 4y is congruent to 7 mod 14. The first step will be to check whether such a system is solvable or not. So we will first form the determinant 5 into 4 minus 3 into minus 3, which gives us 29. And we can see the GCD of this determinant and the modulus 14 is 1. So the system is solvable. The method we are going to use to solve such a system is the elimination method. Let's see how it works. Now, we are given two congruents. You can see here 5x plus 3y is congruent to 2 mod 14 and minus 3x plus 4y is congruent to 7 mod 14. Here, the first congruence, if that is multiplied by 3 and the second congruence is multiplied by 5, we can make the coefficient of x same. Same thing we can do for y also. So, which means that we will try to make coefficient of any one variable equal. Let's say we make the coefficient of x same. So, we multiplied the first congruence by 3, second one by 5. And this gives us 15x plus 9y is congruent to 6 mod 14 and minus 15x plus 20y is congruent to 35 mod 14. We can always add left and right hand sides of a congruence if the moduli is same. So here we do the same thing. We will add the two congruents and we will get 29y is congruent to 41 mod 14. The x terms vanish. And this is easily, we can easily solve this and we get y is congruent to 41 mod 14. What I did here was I replaced 29 by its residue mod 14. So, we know that 29, if we subtract 1 from that, we'll get 28. So 1 is the residue. We get y is congruent to 41 mod 14. You can do the same thing with 41 also. You can reduce it by its residue mod 14. This y value we take as it is, y is congruent to 41, and substitute in any one congruence. Let's say we substitute it in the first congruence. So in place of y, we've put 41. We get 5x plus 123 is congruent to 2 mod 14. We will get 5x is congruent to minus 121 mod 14. We took this 123 on the other side. And this has to be solved for x. So one way is we will write it as 5x plus 121 divided by 14 is equal to k, which is some variable, and simplify that and get 5x minus 14k is equal to minus 121. We can see it has reduced to a Diophantine equation, and this has to be solved for x. We do not need k value. So, initial solution, we get 5 into 3 minus 14 into 1 gives us 1, because 5 and 14, they are relatively prime. So, we can find integers x and y such that we write it as a linear combination of the GCD. But our equation had minus 121 on the right hand side. So we will multiply all over by minus 121, and this is what we get. This gives us x naught is minus 363, and we can write it as x is minus 363 plus 14t. So the solution becomes x is congruent to 1 mod 14 and y is congruent to 41 mod 14. If you want to check your answer is correct or not, just take x as 1 and y is 41 and substitute in both your congruence. You will see both the congruence are satisfied simultaneously. 5 into 1, we've put x as 1. We've put y is 41 in the first congruence. We see that 5 plus 123 minus this 2 is divisible by 14. It gives us 9. And in the second congruence, minus 3 plus 164 minus 7 is divisible by 14 again, and it gives us 9. So our system is solvable. Thank you for watching.